we're going to use a technique called pin marking to transfer this dart from my pattern to both layers of fabric underneath. All I need for this is some chalk, a pair of scissors, ruler, and my pattern and my fabric. So to get started, I'm just going to anchor my paper pattern at the top of the dart and then release the pins that I used when I cut out my dart. At either end of the dart, I'm going to cut a little snip or a notch, which will help me line up my darts. Then I'm going to put a pin all the way through, right through both layers, where my circle is. And then I have another circle here. So I'm putting a pin through the middle of this circle, sliding it all the way through both layers of fabric. I'm folding my paper pattern out of the way, folding the first layer of fabric and just sliding along the pins. Then using some tailor's chalk, I'm just going to put a mark right where that pin is there, and another mark right where that pin is, and the same on this side. And then I take these two pins out. To mark the end of my dart, I do exactly the same thing. I fold my paper pattern over, fold my fabric, and using my chalk, I'm just going to mark the end of that dart and the end of this dart. And I'm going to release my paper pattern. So when I fold this back now, I've got a little blue dot at the end of my dart and one here and here and those two nicks. A little trick that I like to do is to draw in my dart. I'm matching the point of my dart, the second notch, and the end of my dart. And then I just draw a line in between those three spots. And then again on the opposite side, matching the top, drawing through the centre, coming out to where my notch is. And you can see I've got a nice sewing line drawn in, and I just need to repeat on the opposite side. When I come to sew my dart, I want to pinch at the end of the dart, and I put a pin a half centimetre on the horizontal at the end of my dart. Then I'm going to lift up, and I'm matching little notch that I put in the end of my dart, and I'm pinning through the middle, matching the chalk on the opposite side. So now I hold this little fold, and you can see having the chalk line makes it really easy to pin and sew. So I'm pinning, matching the opposite side, pinning, making sure it matches the opposite side, right down to the point. So I've pinned along my dart, and now I'm ready to take that to the sewing machine. You always sew an open dart like this, or a triangular dart, from the fat end or the open end. Don't sew it from the point. So I'm just lining up my dart, lowering my foot, taking out my first pin, and now I'm going to sew a couple of stitches, reverse, not quite off the end, and I'm just using my chalk mark as a guide, taking out my pins, as I sew. And when I come to the end, I just want to float right off the point of the dart without back stitching. And then I'm going to leave a long tail so I can knot that. So this is the very end of my dart where I didn't do any reversing, but I left a long tail. And in order to avoid getting a kind of blip at the bottom of my dart, I'm just going to knot my threads. And this means that I get a very gentle end on my dart. So I've knotted that several times, and just to make sure that it doesn't unravel in the wash, I'm going to cut it a good centimetre and a half away from the end. So I've got a little short tail at the bottom of my dart, and this means that in the wash it won't fray away into my knot. This gives me a really light end to my dart. Final stage of my dart is to press it. First of all, I'm going to press over the stitching, not beyond the point of the dart, and this just stretches out my stitching and smooths it. Then I'm going to open out my trouser. I like to press the bulk over towards the side seam. That makes the middle of my back look nice and smooth. And I start the process by finger pressing. I just run my fingers up and down the stitching. Then I'm just going to hold the area of fabric beyond my dart up, because I'm pressing flat without a pressing aid. And then I'm pressing right up to the point, holding that fabric. Then I'm going to swap, and holding the dart, I'm just going to press into the area below my dart. Now what this does is it stops you having any little pleats or bumpy bits at the bottom of your dart. Just give it one last quick press from the right side. And you can see I've got a very nicely pressed flat dart that's just going to create some curve from the waist over to the hips.